Welcome to POSIM's Shopify Linker Overview. In this video, we will explain how the linker works that connect POSIM to your Shopify website. So, let's dive right in. When you run the linker, it loads any items that were updated since the last time it was run. When POSIM loads items into the queue, the linker then pushes most item fields up to Shopify. For example, pushed fields may include the categorization fields, the fields within the web tab, available quantity, vendor name, current price, and the description. The linker is typically scheduled to run every 15 minutes, but you can choose to run it manually for a quicker turnaround. Keep in mind that your server computer must be on and connected to the internet for the linker to connect to Shopify. It is a good idea to add a shortcut on your desktop which can be double-clicked to run the linker manually. If the shortcut is gone, you can search your computer for Run Shopify Linker and the command and batch file should appear. To run it, simply double-click the file. You also have the option to create a shortcut or alias by right-clicking and pressing Create Shortcut and Alias. It is important to know that all your item field settings in POSIM override the settings in Shopify. For example, if you edit the price of a linked item within Shopify, the next time you run the linker, that item's fields will overwrite the changes made on Shopify with the current POSIM data. However, this does not apply to images. You can add additional images on Shopify that will not be overridden by POSIM. Okay, let's move on. The linker queue will display all items that have changed in POSIM and need to be updated in Shopify. When the linker runs, it will remove each item from the queue as they push up to Shopify. If the linker is finished running and items are still in the queue, most likely an error occurred. After 3 attempts, the linker will stop trying to update any remaining items, and they must be cleared from the queue before trying again. The linker also allows orders placed online in Shopify to pull into POSIM. This will start one of two possible scenarios in POSIM. 1. POSIM finds a matching customer by email or phone number. In this case, the POSIM customer card would be used on the invoice created in Shopify. Or 2. POSIM does not find any matching information. In this case, POSIM will generate a new customer card using the customer data pulled down from Shopify. If POSIM does not find an exact data match, but does have that customer card within POSIM, you have the option to merge that customer's data from Shopify with the existing POSIM customer card. This is done through the Customer Merge tool found in the Administration tab under Utilities. Before we dive deeper into how POSIM and Shopify interact, we want to point out that POSIM gift cards can only be applied to in-store purchases. Likewise, Shopify gift cards can only be applied on Shopify. The balances do not currently interact at this time. Now that you have an overview of how the Shopify linker works with POSIM, you're ready to watch our second video in this series, Using Your Shopify Linker, for a more in-depth look at different ways to use your new linker. Thanks for watching.